Well, do you really know what food choices are the best when it comes to your heart?
A local cardiologist says there is a good chance you've been misinformed. So tonight, in a special medical alert, 11 News' Donna Hamilton puts your knowledge to the test.
That cardiologist is University of Maryland Dr. Robert Vogel. He believes in making lifestyle changes rather than relying strictly on medications. But first, you have to know what choices are best for you. Here's our heart lifestyle quiz.
Question number one in your lifestyle quiz. What's the best advice for your heart? Eat less fat, eat more fiber, or eat more fish? The answer?
The polyunsaturated fat, the omega-3s, the fish oils. These are the kinds of things that we know prevent heart disease. And so the best kind of advice is to eat the kind of fat that's really good, which is eat more fish.
Number two. How much more would you weigh in 5 years if you ate one more 100-calorie cookie every day? Add up that 100 calories a day, which adds up to a pound a month. So in 5 years, you've gained 50 pounds. Ouch! The good news?
You take 100 calories, a slice of bread, a pat of butter, out of your diet, and you're going to lose 50 pounds in 5 years.
Dr. Vogel, which is healthier for you, olive oil or canola oil? And I think the answer to this is going to surprise a lot of people. It did me.
Olive oil is not as healthy for you as canola oil. Olive oil has a lot of saturated fat in it. If you don't believe me, put it in a little bowl, put it in the refrigerator, and it's going to look like lard in a day or two.
So we thought we'd save you the trouble of doing that experiment. We have done it ourselves. Let's take a look. Wow. Huh. That's the olive oil. Look at it. Totally solid. And there's the canola oil. That says it all.
Number four. Which contains more sodium, cornflakes or potato chips? And don't forget, sodium can raise blood pressure, which can lead to heart disease.
So the answer to your question is a portion of bread or its equivalent, cereal, has more sodium than a pickle or a portion of potato chips.
And most of the sodium in our diets is hidden in foods that don't taste salty. Number five, who describes their life as less enjoyable, a child with cancer or a child who's obese? An important study a few years back found that thin kids were the happiest. The children who were obese and those being treated for cancer both rated their quality of life much lower. Number six, who benefits more from exercise, a middle-aged person or an elderly person? The answer, an elderly person, because they're more at risk and...
The more that you're at risk, the more that you benefit.
Question number seven, and think about this one, is happiness life-saving? The answer is yes.
Happiness, it's connectedness, it's being a people person, it's being involved with others. We know people like that actually live longer. Being an optimist reduces your risk of dying from heart disease in half.
And getting back to salt intake, the average American ingests about 4,000 milligrams of sodium a day. That's far higher than the recommended 1,500 milligrams. Dr. Vogel says shaking that salt habit can go a long way toward lowering your blood pressure and helping you live a longer, healthier life. Donna Hamilton, WBAL-TV 11 News.
And Dr. Vogel is co-author of a book called The Pritikin Edge. You can read an excerpt from it on WBALTV.com. Just click on Medical Alert.